Keep track. 15 minutes. Yeah, don't let me. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Good morning. I think I'm going to keep. Is it okay if I keep these? Oh, you want me? Yeah, get that up. There we go. Yeah, do you? Okay. Good morning. Thanks again for joining us at one of the FEMA mobile vaccine sites for California. As you know, today's day one for this site. I think very exciting, just how quickly things come together. 250, 300 people today going to receive vaccine. One of the first days the state's using the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, the vaccine I just had the privilege of receiving just now. In a part of our state, in a part of our county that is connected to a community that's been disproportionately impacted by COVID-19, a community where we have a number of African American, Latino community members living here today, seeing lots of brown and black faces getting vaccinated right behind you. I think it's a testament to the outreach and work that we're doing across the state to make sure that those who've been impacted by COVID most deeply get vaccines now. Today, I'm excited to have had a chance to get vaccinated with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, but I'll tell you that any vaccine that you have a chance to get is the right vaccine for you. Johnson & Johnson, one-shot convenience is a nice thing. I certainly like it, but it's, I think, an important milestone for myself, a number of the other leaders, health leaders at the state level, our Surgeon General, our new Director of Public Health, Dr. Tomas Aragon, our state epidemiologist, Dr. Erica Pond, all getting vaccinated today with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Highly effective, effective at preventing the worst complications of COVID, severe disease, hospitalization, death, 100% reduction, avoiding death. So really a high quality vaccine that drives, just like the other two, Pfizer and Moderna, drives us to believe that we're on the cusp here in California, just like we are across the nation, knocking on the door of 11 million vaccines statewide, over 7 million Californians that I joined today who've received a vaccine, and counting, seeing that supply increase coming into the state over the next many weeks into the month of April, delivering on the president's promise that by the end of May, that all eligible Americans, Californians can get access to the vaccine, on the cusp of another important milestone when those with serious underlying conditions and severe disabilities become eligible to receive vaccines next Monday. Really exciting moment in our state's path through this pandemic, recognizing that getting people vaccinated is the way through this, getting communities that have been hardest hit through this vaccinated first is the quickest way through this. We announced last week our focus on equity, our focus on dedicating a significant supply of vaccine, 40%, to some of the hardest hit communities in the state, making sure that we deliver on that promise, not because it's only the right thing to do, not because it's the way to prevent huge surges again in some of the hardest hit communities, but statewide a way through this. So really proud to have a chance to get this vaccine today.
Watch the cave.
Sorry about that.
Can I lift these up?
You guys okay?
You guys all right?
That's fine. You have a nice strong voice.
All right, there we go.
You might just kind of speak up a little because there's a lot of noise.
Yeah, okay. So first off, thank you, Dr. Ramos, for being with us today and available for additional questions in Spanish. And Mr. Lawson, thank you for you, the Urban League, all of the commitment that we see to this community and across LA. It's been a while. It's great to see you again. you know, no doubt the Urban League and so many other community-based organizations. I often have said, the governor has said, that a key strategy to not just crawl back but roar back, as the governor said, as a state, is not just the message around vaccine, but the messenger. Having individuals like Mr. Lawson, who aren't in clinical medicine, who have looked at the information and believe it, and are able to communicate to his community as a leader that this is a vaccine that is safe, that all three of our choices are ones that people should receive, is really, really important. So the message matters, the messenger also matters. Working in counties like Los Angeles, in places like South Los Angeles, the Southside Coalition, a collection of really important community-based clinics here in South LA, out there beating the pavement, not just getting vaccine in their own patients' arms, but also throughout the communities they serve. Little by little, block by block, California is committed to doing that, and it takes the right message, the right messengers, and the supply of vaccines and sites like this to make it happen. Certainly, yeah. I mean, for me, this is an important day as a healthcare provider, making sure that we protect those who are vaccinating, those who are on the front lines, but also a message clearly that those who've been tracking the information, the science very closely at the state level, listening what's coming out of our vaccine manufacturers, the FDA, the CDC, and looking at it, we believe it's important that we step up and get the vaccine ourselves. It sends a signal that, look, it's not just safe for California, it's safe for ourselves, our families, and that's, as a physician, I often say, I never want to give advice to people that I'm not willing to take myself, and this is an example of that, and I think having other state leaders, other physician leaders, other clinical leaders across the state doing the same thing on days before, like Dr. Ramos, on this same day with my other state colleagues, I think is a very important message.
So you're saying that this vaccine, your message is that this vaccine is as good as Pfizer and Moderna, and it's not being, as some have written about, you know, being given here in the African-American community because it's somehow not as good as the other one.
No, I mean, Johnson & Johnson's gonna be distributed widely across the state. It's available in all parts of the state. It's just increasingly available. The FEMA sites did receive it earlier, but are just starting now, just like sites across the entire state. And yes, I believe that this is a great vaccine like the other two, and that's why our message is, get the vaccine that's available for you now. So it's starting to come now, and each county, based on those hardest hit communities, are going to see some, you know, some little bits of increases, others with a larger supply. But the important point is those doses are meant to target those hardest hit communities. So it's not just at large, send them to the counties with the hardest hit, but really getting them targeted into those communities, not just the providers who serve those communities, but actually the people who live in those zip codes, just like we're doing here today.
Governor yesterday mentioned a green tier for the first time. I wonder if you could give us a timeline of when that might, you might see a green tier and what it would include. Would there be masks and other restrictions?
Yeah, it's a great question. We've been talking about what does this look like once we hit a level of vaccines for the state that is meaningful, that gives us a broad range of protection, keeping in mind that yes, we may still need to be wearing masks. Yes, there'll be some scenarios where we'll still need to keep physically distanced as we get through and learn more and more about the virus. But we look forward to that day, and what are going to be the triggers? What are going to be some of those milestones? Definitely led by the level of vaccine penetration in not just our hardest hit communities, but statewide. And then looking at those case numbers, looking at the impact of COVID in our hospitals, we have a sense of what flu does across California, getting closer to scenarios where we're able to feel confident that we're not gonna see extensive surges like we've seen in the past with COVID. That's when we enter that green tier.
Last question.
LA County is behind other counties as far as how many, the people that they're vaccinating. Why is that? And has the county been given enough vaccines?
Yeah, you know, from my look at the numbers, I actually don't think LA County is behind. I think LA County's done a tremendous job. Remember, we started early vaccinating just healthcare workers and people in skilled nursing facilities, long-term care facilities. And now over the last many weeks, with an expansion of who's eligible, more individuals who live throughout our communities, I see LA, like many, many other counties, really doing a good job. But I think we need to be continued focus on our equity principles, making sure that we get vaccine into some of our hardest hit communities. And I think focusing vaccine in that way is something all of us need to do more of. The numbers show that, but we're seeing some improvements little by little.
What does the red tier mean for LA County as far as restaurants and businesses?
Well, the state's position is, and you've seen it all along, that there are some things that begin to happen in the red tier. I also acknowledge, I said it a couple of days ago, that every county is going to make decisions as to how far and fast they move through the state structure of the blueprint. And I think some of those decisions are going to be made here in Los Angeles, a little different than maybe what the state says, and very different than maybe some other counties in the north. So we'll see.
Guys, no more questions. I have to observe the doctor in the observation area. Okay? Thank you.